So basically what we're doing, for those of you who don't know, is we are heading down south and back up to New York all in about a 7-day span. When you head down south, generally, it gets warmer. And when it's March, generally, it's spring, and this doesn't happen. This is why gingers are only 2% of the population, because we are so stubborn and that the elements are always against us, we will not give up till we die. So most of us do die because we're just, I mean, we're not built to last. Pale skin, red hair, so. Hope we live.
Our first stop was in Hershey, Pennsylvania, at the Antique Automobile Club of America Museum. From 75 to 100 cars at any given time, and recognized as one of the top 16 automotive museums in the world, I was more than lucky to be shown around by the museum's curator, Jeff Bleemeister, executive director, Michael Barrett, and the director of marketing and PR, Nancy Gates. I, of course, was great with introductions. Nancy?
Nancy,
nice to meet you.
Great to meet you.
It's good to put a face to the, you know what I mean, face to the sound. Tomato, tomato.
Do you guys use this just exhibitions?
We do changing exhibitions in here. We've got 100th anniversary of Chevrolet next year coming in here.
What is that?
100th anniversary of Chevrolet in 2012.
2012. Keep me posted on that. I will come back for that. I'm a Chevy fan.
We've done everyone, obviously, with your car.
Yeah.
We basically store them with all the gas out of them for safety purposes. When we have to
just
run
in
them,
case. You know, just a bunch of bombs hanging out in here.
That's
makes
exactly
sense.
Exactly right.
The red truck you can sit in, it's a Model TT for ton truck.
All right. My name is Gail Withers. I'm a corn planter. No, 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 I broke it. Which, how do you, this way? I'm going in this way. Okay. My God. What's your insurance policy on this? Does it cover gingers? This is all wood. And this is a design flaw. Right here. How do you, maybe the people were smaller in the day.
Back in that era, you bought chassis and the engine, and you had to build your own cab and body.
So this was built by someone.
So this was built by someone, a design flaw. Maybe that person was 5'1". Maybe
absolutely. They were like,
that because that's really.
Or they had a severe problem with scoliosis, and this is
one of the two.
What they had going on. What is this about? Ladies, look. Mary Anderson invented the first windshield wiper. Woo-hoo! Because we like clean things,
that's
and we
right.
like to see, and we're sensible, instead of looking through something that's mucky.
The first method was actually to put vegetables on there or something and smear it around to clean it. That's the first documented way to clean your windshield.
Vegetables?
For Windex. Yeah, vegetables.
Where was that thought process? Vegetables. Take
vegetables.
It, water and a rag and just
right.
mush it around a little. Or how
and
do you clean yourself? Smart. Are they cleaning themselves with vegetables? We're in another area.
We are.
It's like a hall of mirrors.
Filled with intense nostalgia of the automobile's evolution through time, and giant murals I both loved.
I want this in my room, just this, my room, just a giant mural.
And was a little bit creeped out by.
It'll look at you, no matter where you are.
Well, that's unsettling now. Because he's got this kind of coy smile on his face, like, now he's unsettling.
Everywhere I looked, there was something fantastic.
My God! You see that in the street, you get out of the way.
There was even a diner in this place. The diner was called the Flow Inn Cafe. It got its name from its owner, Florence Fortnoy. The diner dates all the way back to 1941 and was originally located in Wichita, Kansas. In 1983, it closed down, where later the entire building was shipped to Hershey, Pennsylvania, where the museum restored it and now has it on display.
What do we have in the menu? You know you're dedicated when you move an entire building into another building. This is like one of those Russian dolls. It's a building inside of a building, inside of a building. Blowing my mind.
Bum, 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 bum,
Mr. Sandman. Bring me a dream.
Bum, 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 bum.
Make him the cutest that I've
ever. Is that a real person or is that fake? Excuse me, sir? Sir, I want pancakes. You know, it's just 1956. I'm coming in for my chocolate malt. And my friend Boo Boo and Cece are out in their poodle skirts waiting for me in the car.
Connie Francis. Hank Snow. Jim Reeves.
Oh, Johnny Cash.
Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream.
All right. Let's go find the buses. These fake mannequin people are throwing me off because I thought someone in there before was a mannequin and it wasn't a mannequin. And then you had the chef in there who I thought was a person. Now we have James Dean who's slightly taller and has suffered a severe fracture on his face. James, you'll be all right. I'd pull over for her. Or him. Her? Him? What do we got going on here?
They have the largest collection of buses under a roof in the United States. And believe me, they were large.
This is like an airplane on wheels.
Exactly.
Among these big boys was the famous bus used in the movie Forrest Gump.
You can see some photos there on the window, and this is where she was doing the peace sign out the back of the bus.
Oh, it's one of my favorite parts in the movie, too. Jenny. Leo, she should go back to Greenville, Alabama. All right.
I was even lucky enough to go see the cars they had in storage.
Oh, look at these cars. Yeah.
Which I handled like a three-year-old.
There you go.
Oh,
you got it.
My God.
Like
my God. I want that horn. You just imagine that coming out of nowhere. That would give a heart attack to anybody around. A fairy? God?
This museum was a time capsule of awesomeness. Take my advice and go and see it. With less than 7 days, and over 3,500 miles to cover, our journey was just beginning.